IVF is a very good fertility treatment with high pregnancy rates. Doctors and patients are always looking to identify factors which might indicate patients with a lower chance for success. If you are overweight, will this lower your chances for IVF success? Stay tuned. I will present the results of original Infertility TV research to help answer this question. On today's episode, I am discussing the impact of weight on IVF success only. If you are more interested in the effect of weight on your ability to get pregnant naturally, then check out this episode. All of the studies I am going to talk about today use BMI, or body mass index, to investigate the impact of weight. Although it's not perfect, BMI helps us to control for the fact that taller people are going to weigh more than shorter people, even if they are not overweight. BMI categories may differ slightly in different countries. A low BMI indicates that a person is underweight. A high BMI, greater than 25, indicates that a person is overweight. A BMI over 30 is defined as obese. There are also different classes of obesity for people who have a BMI over 35, 40, and so on. In 2013, this study was published looking at over 12,000 couples who had IVF in Denmark. This study concluded that pregnancy rates were lower when female BMI was greater than 25, and even lower pregnancy rate when both partners had a BMI over 25. This was a nice study. Applying that today, however, is difficult for two reasons. First, they looked at couples undergoing a fresh embryo transfer only, which is not done very commonly anymore. And second, they didn't provide information on couples with higher BMIs, such as those greater than 30 or 40, which is much more common today. If increasing weight lowers the chance for IVF success, is it due to an effect on the eggs? Or is it an effect on the uterus or some other factor about the person attempting to carry the pregnancy? A few years later, this study was published using the IVF registry in the USA. This study looked at patients attempting pregnancy using donor eggs. By using embryos from higher quality donated eggs, this kind of study is helpful because it controls for the egg factor. This study also looked at people who had much higher BMIs in the 40, 45, and 50 range. They concluded that compared with people with normal range BMIs, those with higher BMIs had lower pregnancy rates and higher miscarriage rates. This also gives us some idea about couples doing frozen embryo transfers, since the method used to prepare the uterus in donor egg recipients is similar to what we use for frozen embryos. There haven't been any good studies which looked at the effect of weight on the chance for pregnancy specifically with frozen embryo transfers. We decided to do that study. This study was conducted at the Naperville Fertility Center from January until mid-August 2021. During that time, I performed 310 frozen embryo transfers. To prevent skewing the results, we analyzed only the first transfer for each patient. This left us with 253 transfers to analyze. All patients had transfer of a single blastocyst embryo. When we looked at the percentage of patients who had a positive pregnancy test, we saw a definite decline as the BMI increased. This ranged from 89% in the lowest BMI group to 60% in those with a BMI over 40. Some patients miscarried after their positive pregnancy test. To look at the percentage of ongoing pregnancies, we looked at how many patients made it to the point where we were able to see a fetus with heart motion on ultrasound twice a week apart. This is a pretty good indicator for those patients who will go on to deliver a baby. We found a lower pregnancy rate in the patients with a BMI over 30 and a much lower rate, only 20%, in patients with a BMI of 40 and over. We also looked at those patients who used embryos that were tested for chromosome abnormalities. By transferring only normal embryos, we eliminate the impact of age, since younger and older patients have the same pregnancy rate when using normal embryos. As you can see, pregnancy rates still declined in patients as their BMI became higher. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: even when using state-of-the-art IVF techniques, such as frozen embryo transfer, blastocyst transfer, and chromosomally normal embryos, there is still a significant and progressive impact of BMI. The higher the BMI, the lower the chance that an embryo will implant, and the lower the chance that a patient will have a delivery. Patients should be aware that IVF does not overcome these problems. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.